What's up, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. So Apple randomly released iOS 13.1.1 today. So, you know, we got to talk about it, at least on the iPhone 7 and 6S. You know, I dropped the 6S one earlier, but what's really interesting about this update is that it really didn't do anything crazy. I mean, bug fixes and security updates are definitely crazy, but I found something super interesting about this update, which I'll talk about in a second. But looking at this update itself, it wasn't a crazy huge update. Actually, I didn't even screenshot it. I always forget to screenshot it. It was only about like 70 something megabytes or 80 something megabytes. Not a huge one, a very, very small one at that. But at the end of it, at the core of it, it was just a bug fix update. So don't expect battery life to be better. Don't expect, you know, the features to be increased or anything like that. And don't expect the speed to increase either. Or so I thought. Like, I thought the speed wasn't going to increase. And maybe it hasn't, but this is the really, really interesting thing. So when I load up Antutu, right, the score I had before, okay, this was the official version, was 151,727, which is a pretty good score, one of the highest I've seen on my iPhone 7s. But as soon as I re-ran it, I found something so crazy. And I don't understand what this is because it's way across the board. It went up to 185,648. So if you're an iPhone 7 user, you might see a pretty big speed increase going up to iOS 13.1.1, at least from 13 or 13.1, which is pretty crazy to me. You know, before on my iPhone 6S or even all my other iPhones, I've seen a speed decrease going to 13.1, but then that picked up with 13.1.1. So I find that really, really relieving. I'm so happy that Apple's actually, you know, I guess focusing on important things like on the back end that are actually increasing the speed of some of these updates, which is so cool. Now, at the end of the day, do I see it being way faster? Not really. It's like the same exact thing to me. I mean, it's like whatever, honestly. But the good thing is with at least my iPhone 7, I didn't see any huge issues when I went to update. Usually, like I said before, on my 7s and even my 7 pluses, I've usually had like boot loops or random issues or something like that. Now, luckily that didn't happen to me. So I'm really happy about that. I'm happy I don't have to deal with that kind of, you know, constantly going into iTunes and fixing it. So if you're on iOS 13, I would highly recommend you to go to 13.1.1, or even if you're on 13.1, go up to 13.1.1. If you want to wait for a jailbreak on 13, then I guess stay on the lowest version. But ultimately, that's pretty much it. If you guys have any other questions or anything, leave it down in the comment section below. Hit that like button, that would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. Every single subscriber that we get really does count, so it would mean so much if you guys could hit that. Also, check out the other links down in the description as well. My Twitter, my Instagram, my second channel, all those links are linked down below. I'd really appreciate it if you guys could check it out. But more importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. I'll fuck at you guys in the next video. Peace out to them.